is pure, possessing, filthy, wretched, impure, disgusting. All of this is pure.
All this universe is like water. It is fluid, it is transient, it is changing. And the only way to survive in water, and this refers particularly to the waters of modern philosophical confusion, where God is dead, metaphysical propositions are meaningless, and there's nothing really to hang on to. Because we're all just falling apart. And the only thing to do under those circumstances is to learn how to swim. And to swim, you relax. You let go.
system, because it specifically says that there aren't necessarily consequences that you're going to have to pay because of a loophole. And what is the loophole? It has nothing to do with how good you are or how morally you act or anything else. It has to do with whether or not you're willing to be a sycophant to an idea. And if you are, then there is now an exception for which you no longer have to suffer a penalty for this. So the idea that secular morality offers no guarantee that people will ever pay for their crimes and their atrocities is not an argument against secular morality, because that is a tenet of Christianity. It is the foundation. The idea that the Christian God is just is directly contradicted by the idea that the Christian God is merciful. Perfect justice and perfect in any mercy are necessarily directly in contradiction, because mercy is a suspension of justice. So do not pretend that your religion is moral and just and then try to attack my position, which is based on reality, because somebody might rape people, shoot themselves ahead, and then not get punished. That's asinine. Not everything Jesus said is true or good or smart or wise either. So why would you care at all what any of them have to say? You're not concerned about truth. You've already just said you can pick and choose and toss aside the things you don't like. So you're inventing your own version of Christianity. So why not just chuck it aside and go ahead and invent your own secular moral system? You keep talking about how we don't have limits. I have plenty of limits. And we live in a society that has plenty of limits. As Daryl's already pointed out, most societies have limits. You keep going to this slippery slope thing of, well, if there is no, you know, Ten Commandments or Jesus or whatever, then you've got no limits. You'll just run around raping and killing people. Well, that's already demonstrably false. And there have been multiple studies that actually investigate the correlation between the religiosity of a society and its societal health. And there is always a strong negative correlation. The more atheistic the society, the better they score on societal health factors, from everything from teenage pregnancy rates to STDs to happiness to wealth to murder, rape to health care. Now, go out and do some actual research that contradicts this, and then you might have a case for your assertion that I think you'll live a better life if you're... No, you won't. There's no evidence to demonstrate this. This is wishful thinking. Not only have you gone and said, well, I'll pick and choose what I want, you've done it in a way that where you're just trying to support your own wishful thinking. And until you actually come up with evidence, until you demonstrate that you care about the truth,
sorry reminder that inside I will never be fixed. Masking all this pain the best I can, and honestly, I've been doing fine. But sometimes these things slip, the black dog follows, he bites your leg, and snatches you away faster than the speed you can run. It's never permanent, just difficult. It'll fade in and out, good days, bad days, sunny days, rainy days. They're all just days when we learn the best we can with what we have. We'll drive till the sun goes down, make the darkness in our heads external.
bodies are.